oatmeal has been a common breakfast option for centuries. Mixed with warm water or milk, fruit, and nuts, oatmeal can make for an easy-to-create warm and satisfying breakfast. And yes, it can definitely be a healthy alternative to sugary cereals. But is oatmeal actually a good option for diabetics? After all, the more processed the oat, the faster and higher the blood sugar rise. So how can you decide whether or not oatmeal is right for you? Don't go anywhere. We're about to explore the benefits of oats, but also the three big mistakes that can spike your blood sugar. We'll also reveal our three best tips to keep your oatmeal healthy. But before we jump in, can you do us a favor and like this video? Ring the bell for future notifications and make sure you subscribe to Diabetes Smarts for more help battling diabetes. Plus, stick around to find out how you can get two free gifts. Okay, it's time to answer the big question. Is oatmeal good for diabetics? The oat, or Avena Sativa, is a cereal grain, and it can be rolled, crushed, or steel-cut to create the final oatmeal product. They're loaded with protein, vitamins, and dietary fiber. Of course, as a grain, they're also high in carbohydrate content, so it can be a bit of a head-scratcher when it comes to understanding how oats and oatmeal may affect your blood sugar and your overall health. Let's begin our look into this breakfast staple by exploring the three big benefits of oatmeal. Benefit number one, it's low-calorie but nutrition-rich. One cup of oatmeal can contain anywhere between 145 and 215 calories. It also supplies 5.75 grams of beneficial protein, which is a higher amount than most other grains. Protein plays an important role in helping your body slow the release of sugar into the bloodstream. A cup of oatmeal can also give you about 45% of your daily requirement for iron. Iron aids your body in moving oxygen through your bloodstream. And just half a cup of dry oats awards your body with nearly 200% of your daily requirement for manganese. Manganese is essential for bone health, and it's been shown to reduce inflammation. Plus, it may aid your body in insulin secretion and blood sugar stabilization. Oats also supply other important nutrients, including magnesium, zinc, phosphorus, folate, and vitamin B1, otherwise known as thiamine. Multiple studies show that thiamine is excellent for those suffering from diabetes, as it has the ability to reduce high blood pressure, lower blood sugar, and improve insulin levels. Vitamin B1 has also been shown to lower the risk of heart disease. So it seems clear that oat and oatmeal can provide many nutritional benefits for diabetics. Benefit number two, it contains antioxidants and is anti-inflammatory. Yep, oats and oatmeal contain a long list of beneficial nutrients, but its copper, zinc, magnesium, and manganese specifically have been shown to produce anti-inflammatory effects. And oatmeal also supplies polyphenol antioxidants called avenanthramides. These anti-inflammatory compounds increase the levels of nitric oxide in the blood, which helps to decrease blood pressure. While this antioxidant is essential for reducing inflammation, oats and oatmeal are one of the only foods that contain it. So this can be the perfect breakfast food to help reduce inflammation. In fact, various studies show that consuming oatmeal has the ability to reduce long-term inflammation for people with type 2 diabetes. Oats also contain ferulic acid, another polyphenol antioxidant, which is often used to protect skin. Some research now suggests that this antioxidant may help reduce the risk of Alzheimer's disease, cancer, and even diabetes. Benefit number three, it's fiber battles diabetes. One cup of oatmeal can contain about 50 grams of carbohydrates. When a meal is low in fiber and high in carbohydrates, that food is broken down in the body very quickly, and it can cause a dangerous spike in blood sugar. Over 65% of the dry weight of oats is pure carbohydrate, and 85% of those carbs are in the form of starch. But about 25% of the starch content of oats is what is known as resistant starch. This type of starch actually acts much like fiber, as it will move through your body undigested, resistant starch has been shown to aid digestion and can even help reduce blood sugar levels. And on top of the beneficial resistant starch content of oats, one cup of oatmeal also supplies about 10 grams of fiber. Just like resistant starch, the fiber content will help your body better manage that carb load. Plus, oats contain a very special type of diabetes-fighting fiber called beta-glucan. This soluble fiber has been shown to slow down the release of glucose in the small intestine. Beta-glucan forms a thick gel during digestion, which helps to delay the stomach from emptying, as well as slowing down the absorption of glucose into the bloodstream. That's why scientists now believe that beta-glucan is oatmeal's secret diabetes-fighting weapon. And it may help increase feelings of fullness, improve insulin sensitivity, lower blood sugar levels, and remove LDL or bad cholesterol. In fact, a 2015 review noted that type 2 diabetic participants who ate oatmeal daily reduced their cholesterol levels by over 4%. So it's clear that the resistant starch and fiber found within oatmeal can be beneficial for people with diabetes. Okay, so these are just some of the main benefits you'll find with oatmeal. But that doesn't mean that there aren't some health risks associated with this breakfast staple. We're about to reveal three serious mistakes you can make when it comes to choosing oatmeal. Mistakes which may cause a blood sugar spike. But first, it's time to reveal our two free gifts. Discover a wide world of diabetes-fighting, nutrition-packed foods with our free ebook, Superfoods for Diabetics. And learn key secrets about diabetes and your health from leading medical experts in episode 1 of that diabetes documentary. You won't want to miss out on either of these two amazing free gifts. Simply click the link below to grab both. And now it's time for the three oatmeal mistakes. Mistake number 1, eating instant oats. Sure, instant oats are typically inexpensive and, well, quick to make. Unfortunately, this type of oatmeal is not exactly healthy. With a high glycemic index score of 79, instant oatmeal is usually highly refined and is often loaded with carbohydrate content, chemical preservatives, and processed sugars. In fact, certain popular name brand instant oatmeals can supply upwards of 8 grams of added sugar per serving. Plus, the more refined the oat, the less fiber you'll receive. That's why instant oatmeal can cause a blood sugar spike. Plus, it may supply more calories, yet less nutrients than steel-cut or rolled oats. Mistake number 2, adding the wrong toppings. What you eat within your oatmeal can make or break the healthiness within your bowl. So, which pitfalls of oatmeal additives should you avoid? Excessive amounts of dairy milk, added sweeteners, or even too much fruit can all create a negative impact on blood sugar and your weight. Milk can supply a large helping of fat and dairy sugar, or lactose. Added sweeteners, like maple syrup and table sugar, can send your glucose levels through the roof. And even including too much fruit may add unwanted carbohydrates and sugar to your meal. Mistake number 3, eating a large portion. Oatmeal is high in carbs but rich in fiber, which means that it can help you feel full very quickly, as long as you keep your portions in check. But if you overeat oatmeal, your digestive system may struggle to break it down in a healthy manner. While most estimates peg the calorie count of a cup of oatmeal at around 150 to 200 calories, certain processed varieties could supply upwards of 300 calories per serving. And adding milk or fruit will only add extra calories and sugar to your bowl. As a result, your pancreas may become forced to work overtime, and your bloodstream could become flooded with an excessive amount of insulin. While there are no direct studies showing that a large portion of oatmeal spikes blood glucose, it's been proven that eating a large quantity of food, especially carbohydrate-laden foods, can lead to a rise in blood sugar levels and increased insulin resistance. So now that you know the benefits of your oatmeal and the potentially hazardous mistakes to avoid, how can you eat a bowl of oatmeal in a healthy manner? Let's check out 3 tips for keeping your oatmeal healthy. Tip number 1, add the right additions. While it may be tempting to add whole animal milk to your breakfast, choosing an alternative does have its benefits, especially for diabetics. Plant-based milks, like almond, soy, and coconut milk, can increase the nutrient content of your oatmeal without adding extra fat or sugar. Plant milks are cholesterol and lactose-free, but most of these varieties supply healthy mono and polyunsaturated fats, along with extra fiber content. Studies have shown that consuming plant-based milk may improve cholesterol levels, aid in blood pressure regulation, lower LDL cholesterol levels, and reduce the risk of heart disease. However, be mindful to avoid overly processed plant-based milks. Choose the unsweetened options when possible. Beyond the milk, you may feel that your oatmeal still tastes a bit plain. But before you go rushing to add sweetness to your bowl, remember that maple syrup, brown sugar, and even artificial sweeteners can mess with your glucose and insulin levels. If you're looking to sweeten your bowl in a more natural manner, try a sprinkling of cinnamon. This sweet spice is renowned for its many health benefits. In fact, studies show that eating cinnamon regularly may reduce the risk of heart disease and diabetes, aid in blood sugar regulation, and improve brain functionality. Other spices, like ginger, nutmeg, and turmeric, can supply anti-inflammatory properties, so try them out as well. You could even benefit from adding just a tiny bit of honey to your oatmeal. This natural sweetener has been shown to have a low glycemic effect when consumed in small quantities. Tip number 2, choose the right type of oat. All oatmeal comes from oat groats, but not all oatmeal is exactly the same. Steel-cut oats, also known as Irish oats, are the least processed type of oat you can find. Steel-cut oats are often larger in size and take longer to cook compared with other oats. But if you can wait just a bit longer, you'll gain a chewier texture and a higher amount of fiber. Rolled oats, commonly known as old-fashioned oats, are slightly more processed than the steel-cut variety. However, this type of oat still supplies plenty of fiber and a fairly equal amount of nutrition as the steel-cut version. Both of these types of oatmeal are generally low glycemic index, and they will provide plenty of anti-diabetes benefits. So again, it's best to avoid those tempting instant oats, because taking just a bit more time to prepare your oatmeal will aid your health in the long run. Tip number 3. Pair your oatmeal with protein and good fat. Oatmeal can be a nourishing powerhouse for diabetics, but it's still got quite the carb load. To minimize your chances of a blood sugar spike, try pairing your oatmeal with some protein and healthy fats. Both protein and mono or polyunsaturated fats can aid your body in slowing digestion. This helps your system to release sugar into the bloodstream at a healthy, leisurely pace. So, try including a few nuts, like walnuts or almonds, a bit of unsweetened yogurt, or even a small helping of organic peanut butter to your meal. Other healthy sources of protein you can add on the side include mozzarella cheese, eggs, salmon, and avocado. And at the end of the day, as is the case with any food, how much you eat is as important as what you eat. So when it comes to oatmeal, try limiting your daily intake to no more than 1 cup of oats and 1 cup of milk. And of course, if you're managing diabetes, it's best to monitor your blood sugar levels both before and after eating oatmeal to see how it affects your glucose control. But now you know. Oatmeal can, in fact, make its way into your anti-diabetes diet. Just make sure to consume it the right way. Go for rolled or steel-cut oats. Avoid unhealthy additives. Try including a tiny amount of protein and healthy fat. And practice portion control. Following these steps can ensure that your oatmeal is working for, but not against, your health. And now, we want to hear from you. Do you eat oatmeal for breakfast regularly, or have you been avoiding it until now? Share your experience with the Diabetes Smarts community in the comment section below. Before you go, make sure to claim both of your free gifts by clicking the link in the description below. Plus, don't forget to like this vid and subscribe to our channel. We're Diabetes Smarts, and it's our mission to bring you the best tips and tricks to help you fight obesity and diabetes. Thanks for watching. We hope you're having a diabetes-fighting day.